死ぬ。容赦をしない。
Hey, what's up guys, Indian Sense here, welcome back to another episode of Ninja Voltage. Today I'm gonna talk about Rinne Sharingan Sasuke, and he was supposed to come first before Itachi according to the poll, but anyways, I'm here making a video on him now. So Rinne Sharingan was introduced in the combined banner with 6 path Naruto during the second year anniversary, and he was the third best main and a top tier defender. He also got a Sam kit, 1 4 star and an ultimate, which is really not that good. People still use him in defense, I mean I still do, and he's really good in defense, but his ranking in attack mission has gone down. But nevertheless, we are gonna talk about him and why he lags behind. If that sounds interesting, let's jump to episode number 5 of the series. So in attack mission, we are gonna use his complete old kit with the old ultimate, but we are gonna swap out the universal pull with the new 4 star which you got from Sam. And in defense, you can either go with universal pull or the new 4 star. The new 4 star does more damage, so yeah, it's up to you. So starting off with a quick overview of his jutsus. So 3 star flame control, inflicts dot damage and decreases defense of enemies. So which kind of compensates for his lack of high attack. It also can be used to avoid short range ultimates as he goes to the back of the enemy. And the old 4 star Susanoo Chidori. Inflicts small paralysis and increases user's attack power. Is also a very good iframe and can be used to enter final room, almost like DMS Kakashi, but it's not an ultimate, it's just a 4 star. So Sam 4 star Onyx Chidori, it inflicts short paralysis for 3.5 seconds, same as Susanoo Chidori, and damage output is also good and the CP cost is lower than the rest of his jutsus. Now coming on to his old ultimate, Planetary Devastation. It has a good range and if you use it from center, it's almost full room, and it also inflicts large dot effect and also leaves a damaging area for almost like 4 or 5 seconds. The cooldown is an issue though, even at max level with max abilities and stuff, it goes up to like 80 seconds. So he is a green character and his jutsus take up a lot of CP. So you either have to replace one of his jutsus with the default chakra restoration for green characters or give him a lot of CP. But now he will face even more CP issues due to all the chakra eating installations and low damage output against tanky defenders. So if you plan to use him in attack mission, I would strongly recommend taking good supports so that they help you out. So he was a top tier main and he also did a great job in defense, and he is still doing a good job in defense as well now. The problem with him now and before was that the ultimate cooldown is very high and he takes up a lot of CP. Also, his jutsus don't have AoE, they kind of are unidirectional. A lot of times the jutsus miss because the enemy moves around from his jutsu path. So as this game kept introducing other defenders and other attack mission mains, his ranking gradually decreased. As of now, attack mission main he is mid A tier, and defense main he is still S plus tier, and he is better in defense than he is in attack mission. So why did this happen? First of all, he has no trap clear. So either clear traps manually or just use your 4 star Susanoo Chidori, which will save you but not your supports. And the paralysis effect on both of his jutsus is small. Also, it's not guaranteed on both of them, so very risky to use them. All of his jutsus consume almost 100 CP or more than 100 even at max level. So his damage output is very low, especially on tanky defenders. Using jutsus continuously will end up your CP very fast, and ultimate at lower level can only be used twice in attack mission. Even if you use Susanoo to enter final room, it's not guaranteed that the enemies will get paralyzed, so it's very risky there also. He doesn't have any seal, so he has to rely on his jutsus to continuously inflict continuous damage. When up against a high damaging defender, he can easily get one-shotted. Without the help of support, he is not gonna survive in the current meta. Ultimate is not that bad, but the cooldown makes him not ideal for attack mission. His Sam ult has lower cooldown, but it's not even comparable to the first ultimate in any ways. As a defender, he is still S tier league, but if he doesn't get a re-re kit soon, he is gonna be pushed down in the league. So basically, he needs some kind of chakra recovering jutsu and some guaranteed ailment like a medium paralysis or seal and a low cooldown ultimate. Not like his Sam ultimate, it's really not good. If you want to use him in Meta Fortress, then make sure to take top tier supports, because they are gonna help you out so much when you're inflicted with dot damage or something like that. Soloing with him in the current Meta Fortress, especially in Gokunin, with all the chakra eating installations and meta defenders, as I always say, is not advised. As this game keeps on introducing more meta characters, his ranking is just gonna go down much faster, unless he gets some kind of new kit, as we have the leaks of the new 6-path Naruto re-kit. Hopefully Rinnegan Sasuke also gets a better re-kit soon. So coming on to the conclusion, he has a lot of CP problems and low damage output is a concern as well. He needs some good jutsus with good AoE, which can make him a little self-reliant at attack mission especially. You can have fun playing with him team attack missions though. Hopefully he gets a good re-kit which can make him a top tier again. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to drop down a like and comment. What do you think about this video? And if you are new, hit that subscribe button and bell icon. Follow my social medias, links in description. Also, you can watch all the other episodes of this series. They will be in the playlist section. I think the name is Revisiting. I will see you next time. Sayonara.